welcome back. And if you joined us late today, my guest is Dick Jensen, and he is president of something called First Foundations. And he is in the process of taking books now to places that wouldn't have them. I think that's very exciting.
Well, I said in the first part of the program that we had a trial in Russia.
Yeah.
And it worked so beautifully that we are hoping
the same. And they welcomed you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. But we had to work through their contacts.
Yeah.
There, the two or three men in Russia who helped us. One of the men in the education department, I can't remember his name right now, but spoke fluent English. And I went in to speak to him, well, probably months before we actually delivered the books. And then he had to do his research and got back to us and gave us permission to bring them. And then he assigned somebody on his staff to work with us. It was quite a process.
And so now you're in the process of doing almost the same thing.
Yeah, I'm presuming that we have to do it the same way. I'm being very careful not to say too much publicly except for your show until we can say for sure that we've got permission to do it and that we've got permission to take these specific books and that they've got the understanding that they're given with the understanding that those be placed in the library so the students have free access to them.
Yeah. That and was, so you're, you won't just take two books. You're going to have a lot of books, right?
Well, we have researched there are over 50 universities in Cuba.
Yeah.
We're not going to try to send enough of these books for everyone, but in the area around Havana, there are probably 10. And then we'll also put in our agreement for public libraries, just like the Greenville County Library System. We will have some for those in the Havana area. So it's a combination of university libraries and the public libraries that they have. And I'm getting an education now on public libraries in Cuba. It's very interesting.
It's different from our
somewhat,
system.
Somewhat, but I think we're going to be able to get books in those libraries, as long as we pay for them.
But you have to get permission.
Yes.
You can't just give them a gift.
We just, like I said, we just can't get off of the plane with boxes of books and say, here they are. We want to make sure, like we did in Russia, that it's going through the right channels and that the right students will see those books in their libraries. That's important.
So these would be in university and school libraries?
Yeah, in public libraries.
Public libraries as well?
Yeah. Now, we've got a backup plan. I'm not at liberty to say that. Our board will meet in June, and at that time, we will have an option in case this whole thing doesn't work. But we are so confident that with the precedent in Russia, that these folks who have been leaning on Russia for so long will say, okay, it was good enough for them, it's good enough for us. And again, we're not charging them a nickel. We're paying for all the costs of this. We've got a budget of around $10,000. Now, at that point, we need to have some friends step up to the plate and make a donation for the project. I'm not here to raise funds.
No, I know. You didn't come in to talk about money. But www.firstfound.us.
Yes, ma'am. That's our website.
And what? You don't have regular meetings. Or
that's right.
People don't pay dues. It's not an organization like most of us think about.
Yeah. I am repeating myself, but it's a research organization that publishes the results of our research. And I mentioned the pocket constitution, the pocket Declaration of Independence. In addition to the actual literal documents in those little booklets, in those little pamphlets that we have published and are still publishing, we have a commentary. So you have two things. You have the actual document and then a commentary on the Constitution and how important it is to the survival of this republic. And that is another day's story.
Many people right now feel very concerned about the direction this country's taking. And are we really at being tied in closely to our Constitution?
Absolutely. And Peggy, we are, and I will repeat what I said earlier, this is nonpartisan. We don't get into anybody's campaign or anybody's politics. And we staunchly protect that nonpartisanship.
Now we have a phone number, 834-2300, and that's 864. Now, is this strictly a local thing, or is First Foundations anyplace else in the country?
Well, no. No, the headquarters is in Travelers Rest, where my office is. And we have a board of directors, 10 of which, most of which are from South Carolina. We have one in North Carolina, one in Tennessee, and that's probably it. Mostly Carolinas, where these, in Columbia, we have a board member from Columbia. But yeah, we meet periodically. We don't have regular meetings, yeah. And it's just the board of directors who have these projects. And so I guess we're a little different, shall we say, than a lot of 501c3s.
But you feel when you have these books presented to places like Cuba or Russia or something, it opens a door.
We hope it opens our minds. That's the key right there, because not just those two countries, but all over the world, people do not understand what America is all about, what democracy is all about, what the Constitution is all about. And we're trying to get them to understand what made this country great can also make other countries great around the world. And there's a lot of second guessing and thinking going on in Cuba right now. Believe me, there is. I could tell you some stories that have been told to me by pastors who've gone down there, missionary pastors from the United States, and great things are happening down there, and largely among the younger generation. So this fits into that.
Just happening very quietly. It doesn't make the headlines, but it's there.
I was amazed. I'll just tell you one
Please.
Quick. I'll just tell you one quick example. One church in the United States, in the Midwest, sent 50,000 Bibles, 50,000 Bibles to a group of small churches in Cuba.
And these people did not have access to a Bible.
That's right, and I'm relatively sure it was in their language, Spanish. So anyway, yeah, a lot of things are going on behind the scenes, and we're still sort of behind the scenes, and I appreciate your giving us time today to let the public know, because we will need some funds to do this.
We have a phone number for Dick Jensen and First Foundations. If you want more information, he's not here asking for money, but if you want more information about what they are attempting to do and what they have done, that's the number, and I'll keep it here if you want more information and you don't get it now, but it's 834-2300, and of course that's 864.
Yes.
And this is, if you can't promote understanding, then the alternative can be very dangerous.
Yes. And right now, there needs to be a lot of understanding from history, from facts, about what this nation's all about and what any nation can be. You know, we're the light on the hill still.
Yeah. But you don't go to these places and take these books with a holier-than-thou attitude,
no.
Like, we have it all, and this is what you need to do. You
no.
just open the door and present these things, and then they pick it up from there.
We hope.
You just plant the seed.
It's just like that 1935 dictionary I discovered in the biggest university in Russia. It's incredible. The students have to have more current information than that. And that
and
was,
that was 1935, so...
Yeah.
They need an update.
Yeah, exactly. The dictionary was 1935, and I was in their library in 1970.
Yeah.
So, I'm sorry, in 1990. So all those years had passed, and they've got this little beat-up English language dictionary. So that's what we're trying to do, is bring them up to speed, bring them up to date on the documents that have made this country great and can make any country great. We're not picking on Cuba. It's just that they're sort of
resurfacing. Well, they're very close to us. They're our
close
neighbor.
To us. They're close to us, a 30-minute flight, and so forth.
Well, if somebody wants more information about First Foundations, and I guess you welcome questions.
Yes, inquiries. It's on the screen, or will be.
All right. And it's 834-2300-864. Dick, good luck with all the
Thank
things
you.
You're attempting to do.
Thank you.
And I think if you can present knowledge and present what freedom means, what it has meant to us, to other people, open the door. That's all it takes.
One last thing, real quick. I'm available to speak in service clubs, churches, anywhere
all right.
about this.
All
okay?
right. Thank you, Dick Jensen, wherever you are. Thank God we have a constitution that we have. We'll see you next time.